Hey guys, thanks for joining us on the couch, on the big blue couch today from the Brennan's house. We have Lesley Baker, who plays my mum, Angie, and of course Anthony Engleman, who is the Stonefish, the reason why we actually were in the show in the first place. Thank you.
It's all his fault. He was the first Rebecchi.
Yes, and we're going to be answering some questions from you. I love having my family back here on screen. The only person who's missing is Big Kev, so hopefully we'll get him back. I don't know when. Oh, and of course Shane. Shane's missing. Shane's been missing for a while now. He's been in jail for quite a long time.
Yeah, 20 years, in fact. Yes.
For car theft.
Yeah.
Yes.
We're looking at an appeal at some stage.
I won't take it on because he's just no.
No.
Just won't do it.
Yes.
Yeah. But on top of that, we think he's done other stuff in jail as well. Yeah.
Yeah, like he didn't clean up after himself one time.
Yeah. 20 years is a long time.
Yeah.
We think we could do a whole series on the Rebecchis.
We could be. We could have our own spin-off show.
We could.
Yeah.
Yes, we could, definitely.
We could call it the Rebecchis. Just to be different.
To mispronounce it, absolutely. Yeah. That would be perfect.
Yes. We're the Australian Rebecchis.
We are.
Clearly we're not Italian.
And we go to Target and we have lots of...
We still shop at Jewel.
Pinot Noir. And,
we still shop at Jewel.
Jewel.
Yeah. Jewel doesn't even exist anymore.
I'm not even sure what Jewel is, but yeah.
Really?
Why are we back in town?
Why are we back in town?
Well, you see...
Do you know why? Hang on, it's coming. Wait.
I'm not sure. You had a major mishap.
A mishap, yes.
And are
with a bouncy castle.
A whoopsie.
And,
a whoopsie off a bouncy castle.
I come to help nurse him, and then Sonia, who I... beginning to suspect doesn't like me very much.
No, Mum, she loves you.
Does she?
Yeah.
That's why I... Last time she chucked me out. Well, this time I chucked myself out and I left. And then you arrived.
Yes,
why did you arrive?
Well, for very similar reasons to why you're back, to look after or to help with whatever, Toadie needs after his quite large whoopsie. That has him in...
You're not going to wipe my bum, That just sounds wrong.
Incapacitated,
quite a large whoopsie
kind of situation.
it sounds like you've come back because I've done a massive poo in my pants.
No, well, you'd probably have a colostomy bag, probably.
Thanks, Mum.
TMI.
Just bring that up.
TMI moment. Hashtag TMI, that one.
Yeah.
No. We're back here to be a bit more, obviously, of assistance and support through Toadie's rather big news.
I think if these guys return on a more permanent basis, it would just create so many storylines with this constant thing of, oh no, what have they done now?
What have they done now?
It would be a great lot of fun.
It would be. I think we've got some really fantastic, good Australian characters here. So it'd be great to have them back in the show.
Yep. A lot of characters here. A lot of textures. A lot of colours.
Yes.
A lot of colours. And some flavours.
And
some real Aussie flavours.
Wow.
And we'd have all these children running around.
We would. Stoney's still trying. I think Stoney's still trying to have kids.
Mm.
And, he's certainly still capable of it as far as I'm aware.
Well, I'll encourage you. I'll encourage you.
And that's very sweet of you to say.
Yeah.
Lesley.
She's going to be standing on the outside of
bed.
I'm going to pop that outside.
Come on, Stoney, you can do it.
What have I been doing in my real life? Really looking after my disabled son. That's my number one priority. He's now 37 and he's living at home, become very lazy. And that's what I do. I attend conferences. I've been on government panels. Good fun stuff. This is some comic relief.
You come here to get away.
Yes.
Yeah. And I've been, just you know, working. I've got a, you know, business and things like that. Doing
what sort of business?
Consulting.
What do you consult about?
About stories and about things like that. I make videos and I help people, you know, with strategies and things like that.
Wow.
On social media. Things like that. So, yeah, obviously been keeping busy and, yeah, I've got a family as well, so that always keeps me on my toes.
How has Neighbours changed since you've been in here last?
Well, I think Neighbours has changed since I was last here. I think it's actually gotten better. I think the people on it are better. I think it's more, more wholesome, some of the storylines, and they're a bit better fleshed out.
Better written.
I think it's better written.
Oh.
Since I was last here, which was quite a while ago, but you know, hey, that's just me.
Clearly not, because you're not back in it full time.
I just think it's still there's a lot of comfort here, and there's a lot of people that are very, very good at what they do, and they do it very, very efficiently, and if anything, they do it even more efficiently now.
Do the sets look better?
I think they do, actually, yeah.
I think they look pretty much the same.
Really?
I do. But then, who am I to say?
But the walls don't shake as much.
No, this is true.
I think the walls shake less, yeah. Yes. And there's more places to put your, you know, your little bits and pieces while you're working between
scripts. So you can see it.
I've got more drawers. I like drawers, yeah. So I can put my scripts in there and, you know, obviously...
A little more couches to see what's under there.
And the couches are great. Like, I'm not sure who brought this couch to us, but I'll tell you what, they've done a great job
with
this couch.
Thank you.